Hello and welcome to Berks Business. I'm Bob Wert, Managing Director Investments of the Wert Investment Consulting Group of Wells Fargo Advisors. Each month in Berks Business, we bring you the leaders of the local business community and give you the opportunity to call in during our live program on Monday night. Tonight, we have Drs. Natalie Parisi and Denny Mauro with the Reading Orthodontic Group. Welcome to the program.
Thanks for having us.
Let's just jump right in. Tell us a little bit about Reading Orthodontic Group.
Yeah, so RG Orthodontics, we have been in business since 1966 in Wyomissing and recently expanded to the Douglasville area and also to the Pottstown area.
So it's grown quite a bit. What distinguishes your practice from others?
Well, I think the main issue now, dentistry is really changing a lot. As you see medicine changing and becoming more more corporate, more owned by the hospital, we see that in dentistry as well now. And at ROG, we've decided to stay a doctor-owned practice. So the doctors that treat you are actually the people who own your practice.
And why does that make a difference?
Well, I think the biggest thing, the biggest difference is patient care.
Mm-hmm. You know,
anytime you're talking to a doctor, you're talking to an owner of the practice.
Right.
So any issues that might arise, we're handling it. We care about the practice. We care about our patients. The level of care, I think, is much, much higher than you receive anywhere else.
So that'll tend to keep the turnover among the docs limited.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
And why does that matter?
Well, anytime you have turnover in a practice, if a treating doctor decides to leave a practice mid-treatment, mm-hmm. your treatment can oftentimes prolong.
Right.
So a treatment that might take, say, 18 months in a traditional practice with a doctor who's there every time could take much, much longer.
So do you see the same doctor every time you go in? Is that how it works?
Well, not necessarily. In our office, you know, you could see either myself, Dr. Nat, or Dr. DeLiva, our other partner, but we all have the same mindset. We're following each other's treatment plans. We very much kind of practice the same way.
Sure, so that makes a lot of sense. So let's describe the patient experience. I mean, you wake up one morning, you say, oh, I need to go see you.
Mm-hmm.
What happens next?
Well, you know, ideally we like to see kids at age 7 or 8. So most people come because they're referred by their dentist, but you certainly don't have to be.
Right.
You can come to us for any reason. There's no need for dental referral. And when you come in, if you're under the age of 12, typically we'll take an x-ray called a panoramic x-ray that rotates around your head so we can see all the teeth and also the structure of the jaw, because that's really what we're looking at,
right.
And tooth development, tooth eruption patterns. And so then we'll do a clinical exam. One of the doctors will come in, meet you, and do a clinical exam and kind of talk about what's not right about the bite and if now's the right time for treatment.
Mm-hmm.
At age 8, in our practice, only 4% of patients actually get any type of treatment. But it's a great time to be seen because there are a lot of things that can be avoided. The number one thing is impacted canine. So the canine is a tooth that's nicknamed the eye tooth, and that's because it develops so high up toward the eye socket. And so as it comes in, it often heads in the wrong direction if there's any type of crowding. It also happens to be the last tooth to come in. And so because it's the last tooth, I sort of joke with kids that it's like musical chairs. You know, it happens to the last guy that gets there.
Mm.
So it either comes in looking like a fang, which you often see teenagers who have teeth that look like fangs. That's a good thing because at least it came in.
Right.
The flip side of that is that it headed into the roof of the mouth, which is very thick, hard bone, and it becomes impacted. And then there's a surgical procedure needed in order to go get it. So you have braces in combination with a surgery. And
mm-hmm.
the main reason for wanting to see kids at age 8 is that we can avoid that simply by diagnosing that tooth is heading in the wrong direction slightly at that early stage. Maybe take out a baby tooth, which will help guide that tooth into better position. So that's the basic experience of young kids who come in, is that we just take an x-ray. Most need nothing, but some might need to go back to their dentist or to the oral surgeon and get some baby teeth out. Some maybe have lost a baby tooth early and they need to have a holding arch or something placed. And then the 4% that actually need something may need an expander or an early phase of braces for a particular reason, which is usually a crossbite. But if you're not a young child, if you're an adult or a teenager and you come into our office, we take a full set of photos, 2 x-rays, and then we talk to you about what's not right about your teeth, and then we talk about what would be needed, and then you make decisions about what type of treatment you would like to choose. And you really get your option of different types of treatment.
So what kind of range of choices are there?
Well, we have actually 3 main choices that a patient can choose from. Okay. One are your traditional braces that you see, you know, most teenagers with that are on the outside of the teeth. Another choice would be Invisalign.
Okay, so yeah, hold that up so the camera can see it. And what's special about Invisalign?
Invisalign is a series of clear plastic trays,
okay,
custom made for each patient.
Right.
and they align the teeth. You wear the trays every 1 to 2 weeks and change into a new tray.
So what do you mean by a tray?
This is actually...
So it's almost like a retainer.
An Invisalign tray.
Yeah, okay.
Looks just like a clear plastic retainer.
Right.
But there's specific movement built into each tray.
Okay.
So over a series of trays and over a series of time, it puts light pressure on the teeth to move them into place.
Okay. So what's the difference between wearing that as opposed to having the fixed braces?
The most significant difference would be compliance.
Okay.
This is totally patient compliance based.
So the patient actually has to do it, whereas
exactly.
the other things, it's
the other
automatic.
Things are fixed onto the teeth.
Right. So what's the advantage of this program?
Well, the biggest advantage, I think, with Invisalign is it's for lifestyle.
Okay.
A patient who might be talking a lot in front of people, they may have a job that requires or causes them to want to have a more aesthetic choice
right.
rather than having braces on the outside of the teeth, they get to use the Invisalign trays.
Okay. Then the hardest problem, of course, making sure you actually do it.
Absolutely.
Okay. So how about brushing teeth and flossing and sort of things like that?
That is probably the biggest pro for Invisalign because you can take the trays out to brush your teeth and
right.
you're brushing the actual tooth surface and not having to work around any wires or braces.
So
flossing is much easier.
Right, exactly. So probably get more patient compliance in terms of flossing and whatnot if you can actually do it.
Sure.
Yeah, I mean, I think whichever option you choose, there's compliance. So if you choose fixed braces, which, you know, surprisingly, a lot of teenagers want, you know, we'll offer them Invisalign, and not everyone's a candidate for Invisalign because it does have some limitations.
Okay.
Although the product continues to improve, and we've really become experts in using this product. We're the only elite providers of Invisalign in Berks County, which means we do the most of it, and we're the most experienced.
Okay.
But some kids just say, hey, I want braces. But the compliance with braces is that they have to be ready to spend extra time to brush and floss
right.
around their teeth in the morning and at night. It's difficult. And, you know, it's kind of like, you know, driving down the highway. You can drive really fast, right, when there's nothing there. That's like brushing your teeth with nothing on,
right.
no braces on. You know, but when you have a lot of obstacles to get around, you're brushing your teeth, it's going to take you more time. So the compliance with braces is really the brushing and avoiding hard and sticky foods.
Okay.
The compliance with Invisalign is simply wearing them. And when kids get in the habit of this, or adults, it becomes pretty simple.
Okay. So you mentioned that kids versus adults. What are the majority of people you see, young kids, teenagers, adults? Or?
Right now, about 25% of our practice is adults. But new patient exam for adults is way up. That's really... I think that these, especially Invisalign,
right.
but we also are going to talk a little bit today about braces on the inside of teeth.
Yes.
And I think that those aesthetic options for patients are really driving adult patients in. And then we're going to talk tonight a little bit, too, about the customized braces just in general.
Right.
And the fact that adults don't have to wear their braces as long has really driven patients to our office. So, you know, recently we just finished a woman who's an optometrist, and she was in and out of braces. She chose the outside braces. In 10 months. And she was like, that was easy. But we really find that the 15-month mark
right.
is kind of it for adults. They're in it and they're enthusiastic. And then, at 12 months, they're like, when am I getting these off? And at 15 months, they're really like, okay, I'm done. I need to be done. And so that's really what we've looked for is we now use customized braces, which allow patients to be in treatment time a much shorter period of time.
What's the difference between, say, a teenager and adult in terms of time and or treatment?
Really, not much.
Okay.
You know, it used to be kind of a... It was an old wives' tale that when you got braces on and you were older, the bone didn't move as well, the teeth wouldn't move as well through the bone, and it's just not true. So it's not. There are some limitations in adults in that they're not growing. Okay, so
right.
in an adult patient who has a very weak chin, if they want their chin to be forward, they're going to have jaw surgery in combination with the braces. Whereas a child could wear an appliance called a HERPS, which is an orthopedic appliance that encourages horizontal jaw growth, and you can improve the chin projection with that. So there are some limitations in an adult.
Right.
But the actual tooth movement through the bone really is not different. It's just bone metabolism.
Okay.
And our bones are changing all the time. You know, you lift weights, right? And your bones get stronger. They tell you to keep lifting weights to do that. So it's the same in kids or adults. So really it doesn't move faster or slower in an adult.
Okay. And then you have a third version where the braces are on the inside. What's
correct.
That?
This is our third option, and it's called Incognito. They're lingual braces, so it's customized braces.
What does that mean, lingual brace?
They're on the inside of the teeth,
okay.
so on the lingual surface of the teeth. That's where we attach the braces and the wires, and it's the most aesthetic option that we have because there's absolutely nothing showing on the outside of the
right.
teeth.
So is that something a lot of people are switching to, or is that the trend? Or is...
I'd say people who are most concerned about aesthetics,
right.
Someone who may be into acting or modeling or...
Sure.
lawyers, car salesmen, whatnot. Those mm-hmm. are all people that I've treated with these braces.
Okay.
At ROG, we're the only center of excellence in the state of Pennsylvania.
What is a center of excellence?
A center of excellence basically means that we do more lingual braces than anyone in the state.
Okay. And so why do you think that is? And why are you getting more of that kind of work done?
Really because I decided that it was something that I wanted to differentiate myself as an orthodontist mm-hmm. and do something that not a lot of orthodontists were doing. Lingual braces were popular back in the 70s, mm-hmm. I'd say, yeah. early 80s,
right.
and kind of fell out of favor. They're a bit more difficult to learn how to master.
Sure.
And I've taken the time to do that.
Yeah, you would think it'd be a little harder to access when you're working on a patient.
It is.
Yeah.
There's a learning curve. There's a learning curve for sure.
And so in terms of cost of these different treatments, how do they vary?
Well, it really depends on the case. So okay. the level of difficulty for the case will determine exactly okay. how much you're paying for treatment. Mm-hmm. Braces and Invisalign, regular braces and Invisalign are typically about the same. Okay. There is a little bit more cost for incognito, the right. braces on the inside of the teeth. It just costs a little more to design and make them.
Well, that makes sense. So tell me about the range of cases that you see, I mean, in terms of age and severity and that sort of thing.
Well, probably the youngest patient we've ever treated is 4,
okay.
who had a severe tongue thrust habit that was causing a really large open bite. Mm-hmm. And then the oldest patient we've treated is 82 years old. Mm. And so it's really, but that segment, you know, the 70 to 80 year olds is really starting to grow because people know they're living longer.
Right.
And they're finding that, you know, their dentist is starting to educate them that, you know, if you don't fix this, you're going to lose some teeth.
Right.
You know, sometimes patients will walk into our office and they're in their early 70s and they have a very loose upper right front tooth, say, and it's because they're banging on the tooth. So they realize that the occlusion, the traumatic occlusion, is what's making that happen. You know, and so so that age group is really starting to grow and saying, "Gosh, I never wore braces.
Right.
I never thought I would, but now I realize that I need them."
Okay. I understand we have a home viewer question, so let's take a moment and take that. Yes. We had the home viewer? All right, maybe not. Moving on. Okay, so let's get back to again what distinguishes your practice yeah. from others
I'd like to just address that a little bit because with this, you know, what we consider corporate dentistry coming in, and you people probably see that there's a lot of chain dentistry out there, mm-hmm. and they realize that when they go there, they do take a lot of insurances, and that often is what drives the patient there, but that they don't see the same dentist every time. And then in orthodontics, what happens is not only do they not see them, like in our practice, you might see Dr. Mauro one visit, and then you might see me the next. But Dr. Mauro is still here. So if you had a question right. or you thought something wasn't going smoothly, you could say, I really have to talk to Dr. Mauro. And what happens in these corporate chains is that the orthodontist leaves. Mm-hmm. And you know, in corporate dentistry, I think that's not great. So in general dentistry, what I mean. So for let's say an example is, in general dentistry, you get a crown on your tooth. Okay? And then, you know, 6 months later, you see that, you know, maybe that crown isn't working out so well. If you're the dentist, you can say, well, I'm going to retreat that for free.
Right.
In corporate dentistry, you might not have, you don't own the practice, you may not be able to say that.
Right.
But in orthodontics, it's even worse because your treatment goes on for 18 months. So if the orthodontist is coming and leaving, you don't even have the same person there from the beginning to the end of your treatment. Right. So the continuity of care is just not there.
That makes sense. Now, I believe I had that home viewer back, so let's try that again. Yes.
Hello, I have a question about one tooth. Say you have your front tooth that is really need, you know, braces. What would the expense be for that? And number two, do you accept dental insurance for braces?
Want me to take it?
Do you?
All right. So, so for one tooth, it really depends, because sometimes you may think that just one tooth is crooked, but there's a whole bunch of issues going on that are leading to that one tooth being crooked. But if it were truly one tooth being crooked, you probably could use something that like Invisalign, but maybe even a modified product of that to just get that tooth back in line. And Invisalign's great because it has 3D controls, where you're not just tipping it like you would with a retainer. A lot of patients come in and say, I really just think I need a retainer. And retainers only tip teeth. So if it truly were just one tooth, you know, you could probably do something like a modified Invisalign treatment, or what we call Invisalign Express. And just to know that the consultations in our office are free of charge. So if you just have one tooth and you want to ask about it and come in and have it looked at, it doesn't cost you anything to do that and find out, is this a bigger deal than I thought, or is it truly just this one tooth? And then at ROG Orthodontics, we work with all types of insurance companies. It depends on your insurance. Some limit it to just children, or maybe your insurance stops at age 21. But others do have adult orthodontic coverage. And so you just have to find out. But we work with hundreds of insurance companies, and we can find out for you, even before your first appointment, what benefit you would get. So when we give you about what the cost of treatment would be at that time, you'd also know what your insurance is going to cover for you.
All right, does that answer your question?
All right, thank you.
All right.
You're welcome.
Yes, it did. Thank you so much.
Thanks for calling in. So I believe you brought some slides along, too.
Yeah, so you know, at ROG, we're using customized braces. And when we say that, what's happening now is instead of placing a stock bracket on your tooth, because we know that everybody, say you look at your upper right front tooth, is a slightly different shape. And so yours isn't the same as Denny's, and it's not the same as mine.
Right.
But most orthodontists put a stock bracket on that tooth and try to get it to work out. And so what we do is we actually scan the teeth, and that is a digital scan, so we don't take those yucky molds anymore.
Oh, yeah.
We send it to a company, and we talk to them about how we want your teeth to move. Mm-hmm. And then in about 2 weeks, we start virtually straightening your teeth on the computer screen. And what this does is it allows us to find out any maybe discrepancies that you might have that we couldn't see while the teeth were crooked, because we've already straightened them on the computer screen, and then we know some of those problems that may have occurred during treatment. So it allows us to keep treatment time as short as possible, because we've really taken care of all the problems ahead of time.
So the idea is to work backwards, say this is the outcome we desire, then this is where we are, and how do we work back to get to that point?
Exactly.
Yeah, so I just wanted to show you maybe a couple cases, if we can jump to the computer screen.
Sure.
A couple cases here that just show, so this is an adult patient who has a crossbite, meaning the upper teeth are caught inside the lower teeth, and here she is after treatment. Okay, and so this is a fairly difficult case, what we call a class 3, where the lower jaw is stronger, but with the computerized braces, this was 6 appointments in our office of treatment, and just 10 months in treatment. Okay, and so here's the digital setup on the right, the lower right-hand side of the screen, is the digital setup of what we thought the patient was going to look like before we ever put braces on her. And then you can see as she finished at the end of treatment, there she is with a very similar look. So we really can get very close to what we predict in our computerized setup.
So it takes the guesswork out.
It takes a lot of the guesswork out. Right. And so that's what lengthens treatment time, because at the end of treatment, you come in, you're like, oh, that one tooth not quite right. I'm going to put a bend in the wire. I'll see you back in 4 weeks. Let's see how that worked.
Right.
And a lot of that guesswork. So this is another patient, just another adult patient, just a little bit more complicated. He happens to have a lot of lower crowding. You can see the improved smile aesthetics that he gets, how much better and brighter his smile looks. And here he is after treatment. And then again, 13 appointments, 2 of them were emergencies where maybe he had a bracket loose, okay, or a wire that was poking a little bit.
Right.
17 months in treatment, and here's his finished result, and here's his computerized results. So we know that we can predict and get pretty close to treatment, and there really aren't any orthodontists in this area doing this type of work. And we're doing this with either braces on the outside, which we call insignia, or we're doing it with the Invisalign, which is also computerized setups ahead of time, or with the Incognito. So they're all digitized, computerized, customized braces. You get to choose which mode you want.
So that's part of the initial consultation.
Mm-hmm.
So you sit down and you present what the options are.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Do you have some more slides to go on?
I don't have any more as far as that goes. But I think we could talk maybe just a little bit more about some early treatment issues. I think that a lot of patients, we hear a lot of dentists telling us that, we recommended that you come at age 8 because that's what the American Association of Orthodontists recommends.
Right.
And they're saying my patients don't want to come. And so we want people to know that that appointment is free of charge, and that includes the x-ray. And it's really just a way for patients to find out, is everything okay? Can I wait till I'm 12 or 13 when I normally would think I need braces?
Right.
And again, 96% of those in our practice don't get braces till they have all their adult teeth. But it's best to be seen early so that you can make sure that you're not missing anything, something like an impacted canine, which could become a really big deal.
Right. So you go through the whole process, you get your braces, you have the time when they come off. What happens next?
Yeah, that's a great thing to talk about. So do you want to talk about guaranteeing my smile? And
oh, absolutely. Mm-hmm. So after the braces come off, you'll go into retention.
Right.
So retention is typically a removable retainer on the top, a bonded retainer from canine to canine on the lower arch in our office. So it looks very similar to what the lingual braces look like.
Right.
It's just a bar that goes from canine to canine.
So you literally wear that for the rest of your life?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. And a retainer that may go over that to make sure that nothing shifts.
Okay.
Okay. We use that bar because this is typically where we see most relapse after right. orthodontics. Those lower front teeth
right.
always tend to want to move around a bit. And it has to do with bone remodeling constantly through our life.
Okay.
So we use that bar and a retainer over that to try to guarantee that nothing's going to shift.
Right.
At ROG, we have a few different programs that you can be involved with to have a lifetime of retainers.
Okay.
We have a retainer replacement program.
Okay.
That entitles people to replacement retainers for the rest of their life.
Okay.
One per quarter. Which is a great investment, especially for kids going off to college that might lose their retainers, or you know, young teenagers who might lose them in their room, or
it's been known to happen.
The dogs that may get them in the middle of the night.
Sure.
We also have a few options where you can buy multiple retainers at kind of a discounted price
okay.
right after treatment has ended. For those who may have lost their retainers, or the retainer had broken, or they had been treated years ago and stopped wearing the retainers, we have something called Guarantee My Smile.
Okay.
Now, at ROG, Guarantee My Smile, we will put the braces back on your teeth for free.
Okay.
And then we charge a small monthly fee to treat you until you're happy.
Right.
So you have a few teeth that may have misaligned. Once you're happy with your teeth again, we take the braces off, and then you'll go back into a retainer program.
So you can literally be a patient there for quite a while and just have touch-up and things like that.
Sure.
What happens if you have all this orthodontic work goes on, you don't necessarily take care of your teeth perfectly, and you have a cavity or teeth has to be pulled and mm-hmm. and all that, and you still have the retainers and whatnot, like you had that bar in there, mm-hmm. but now all of a sudden one of those teeth has to be removed. What do you do?
Well, first of all, you'd want to see your general dentist to have any care that you might
right.
you might need. Secondly, you'd come back to us for a different type of retainer, or a new retainer that needs to be made to fit over whatever work has been done.
Okay.
I think it's really important for people to know that at ROG we guarantee my smile, because a lot of people, they may say, oh, I had braces there 30 years ago, 50 right. years ago even, right. right? And now I've got these teeth, these lower teeth are crooked, but I really don't want to go and invest $6,000 in braces, and know that if you already had treatment in our office, you're not going to have to do that. You're just going to come in and we're going to put braces back on you for free. And if you decide you want Invisalign, then you pay the lab fee for Invisalign plus the maintenance, the monthly maintenance fee.
Okay.
But a lot of people come back and they'll say, oh, I don't really want braces. It's not they don't want braces. It's that they don't want to pay for braces.
Well,
and
course.
So they, yeah. And so yeah. what they can know is if they were treated here before, or what you know if you've never had braces and you're having your teen treated right. in our office, you know that, hey, when she gets to be 30, if for some reason she wants braces again, she can go back to ROG and she's going to get them back on for free.
Terrific.
I think it's important for people to know that that investment, they're not right. making it just for now,
great.
But they're making it for a lifetime.
Well, your teeth are hopefully with you for a lifetime.
That's
so
right.
It's important. Process. Yeah. Well, I'd like to thank you both for being on the program.
My pleasure. Right. Thanks
for having us.
Dr. Natalie Parisi and Dr. Denny Mauro of ROG Orthodontics.
Yeah. ROG Orthodontics.
Takes me a while to get used to that.
Yep.
And in both on Penn Avenue in Wyomissing, Pottstown, and on in Douglasville.
Yeah.
Right. Thank you very much. I'm Bob Wert, Managing Director of Investments, the Wert Investment Consulting Group of Wells Fargo Advisors. Appreciate your watching our live program on Monday night for Berks Business, and we'll also have replays throughout the week.